All right, check this out. This is a 2012 Ford Mustang Boss 302. It's an actual boss car. It's got an Aluminator crate engine in it and a Procharger P1X. Pump gas deal still. It's got a ID 1050X's injectors. I believe it's a factory fuel pump with just a booster pump on it. Car super nice. Looks good with these beadlocks. These S197s, all I mean, everything looks good with beadlocks, to be honest. But super nice car. Excuse the door dinger a second there. Stick shift deal on T82 car still. These guys just did a handful of suspension upgrades to it, hoping to better their 60-foot. I put a two-step on it when it was here. And just freeing up a little bit of power. I didn't do a baseline hit on it, but go through some drivability issues and see what we can make. And then they're gonna go do sick week with this thing in Florida here in a couple weeks. So just trying to get it dialed in for that. So yeah, we'll dive into it and see what it makes. We made 602, 437. I made peak power as a typical centrifugal fashion, way out 7,900. Again, it's an Aluminator, so it's got good stuff on the bottom of it, so we can turn it some RPM. Power graph looks good. And we're only 67% injector duty. So these guys are gonna try to source a pulley belt setup for me quick so we can try to turn this thing up a bit, as we've got room both on the engine side, the blower side, and the fuel system side. So no reason to not turn it up at this point. So hopefully they can get some talking about next day in me pulleys, so we can mix a little more jam with it. But yeah, not bad for a street car. They want to dip into the nines with the car. I think it's tracked pretty well. I think we're gonna need a touch more horsepower. It's gonna get a 9-second hit out of it. Even not a bunch of peak, but some more in the middle for sure. Which being a centrifugal style supercharger, the only way we make more in the middle and less peak is if we run out of fuel system and have to bump the rev limiter down. But we will see what happens with it and then go from there. If it comes back or if we make a pulley change the next couple days, I'll make another video, do a before and after. I know the glare is horrible from that, but definitely a nice piece. This thing doesn't have very many miles on it. These guys have a couple nice cars. If you watched previously, there was I can't remember what year, early 50s Ford Thunderbird we did with a Kazi big block in it. That's these same brothers, Smith Brothers Motorsports, here local to me. So check that video out if you haven't seen it. But yeah, that's it for this one for now. See what we can do next.